Hey everybody, RetroPie guy here. Today I'm going to show you around this backlit mini keyboard. This is a fully wireless keyboard here. It plugs in through your USB port through a receiver, so it's great for Raspberry Pi and RetroPie systems. And I highly recommend having a keyboard like this just as a backup. You know, if you ever had an issue with your gamepad controller's input configuration, which does happen from time to time, especially with some of the newer updates, we have run into that issue quite a bit recently, actually. So if you have an issue where, for some reason, your gamepad controller is not connecting to your system, and now you've booted in because it does recognize that your controller is actually connected, but you're not getting any feedback or connection between the two, you end up booting up to a system that you can't navigate anything on. So the nice thing about a keyboard is you can just plug your keyboard in and you're able to navigate. You don't have to go through the mapping process or anything like that. So at the very least, you can navigate into your settings, jump into your input configuration reset option, reset that reboot, and you'd be able to actually go in and fully reconfigure your gamepad controllers. So in situations like that where you need to troubleshoot or go into your various settings or enter Wi-Fi credentials, all that type of stuff, you need a keyboard, and this is super compact. You can see on the palm of my hand, it fits right in there perfectly. So we're talking about 5.5 inches end to end. It's got this really nice curved layout here, so it fits perfectly in your hand, kind of like a gamepad controller would. You have the touchscreen up here, which you can use as a mouse pad, which is nice. You know, if you have your cursor for some of the computer games on RetroPie, you just navigate along here, and then you don't have the setup where you'd have a keyboard and then a mouse on the side. Everything is fully integrated into this exact setup here. The other nice thing is your arrow keys are here with the OK option, which acts as an enter button. So the other nice thing about this is you actually have all your play functions over here. So you can, you know, if you're utilizing the Kodi port, for example, and you're watching videos or movies, you can use all these options here. You can have your play, pause, fast forward, rewind, volume up, volume down. All those are integrated right here into this one circular button here. So you don't have to go in with your touchpad or your cursor, you know, navigating to all those settings on the screen. They're all right here and easy to access. The other nice thing is with the touchpad here, we can also utilize left click, right click. There's also the function over here in the buttons if you want to click that way. So if you're, you know, navigating your cursor here, you can click this way as well, which makes it really nice for old computer games and stuff like that. So now if we walk through this here, we have the back panel here. If we pop that off, we have our battery here. This does come with a charger cable here, so we can just plug that into any USB port and charge the battery. Battery life does last a really long time. And then we also have our USB receiver here. So this is what we would plug into the USB port on our Raspberry Pi. Now this also does work with regular PCs, notebooks, netbooks, tablets, Android TV boxes, smart TVs, Xbox, PlayStation, all that. So you can use this for multiple things. It's not gonna just be for Raspberry Pi and RetroPie systems. So to connect this to a Raspberry Pi, all you're gonna do is grab your Raspberry Pi. I have this case here on it. Access your USB ports here, plug your receiver right in, and that's all you need to do. You don't have to map this, you don't have to go through any of the mapping process. It will automatically pick up your basic functions on here. Now, if you wanted to use this as a gamepad controller, then you should probably go through the mapping process. You know, you'd be able to at least just do the bare minimum there where you do your D-pad, which you just utilize the arrow keys here. And then you just do like the A, B, X, Y buttons. And that would give you just enough functions where you could actually use this for basic gameplay. You could use it for like Super Mario and any of the Nintendo games, Super Nintendo, probably through some of the Sega consoles as well. Just anything with the basic A, B, X, Y, and D-pad functions. Now, it wouldn't probably be a little awkward to use, but totally possible. I've actually tested a lot of systems with this. It works really well. And the fact that it does fit into your hands super nicely does make that a lot easier. So the other nice thing about this is if you're watching a movie, playing a game, and you're in a dark room or anywhere that's not well lit, obviously this would be hard to see. Any keyboard is going to be difficult to see in the dark. So this has three backlit options here. So if we power this on, I'm going to show you how to access these. So say we're in a dark room and we obviously wouldn't be able to see our keyboard really well. We just hit the function and the F2, which doubles as a settings button. And we've just now activated the backlit option here. So anytime we go and hit any button on here, it'll automatically light up. So this is obviously not going to stay lit permanently on here to save the battery life. But in order to enable it again, you just hit any button and it lights right back up. Now there are three options. So you have the green here, we have the blue, and we have the red. And then we just hit it that fourth time and that deactivates it altogether. So if we're using this in the well-lit room like today, obviously we don't need that backlit option, but it is definitely nice to have that. And it looks really cool too. So that's gonna do it for today. I just want to give you a brief tour of this particular mini keyboard here. It's really convenient to have. Like I said before, I definitely recommend anybody with a RetroPie Raspberry Pi system having one of these just as backup in case you ever run into any issues with your input configurations. You definitely want to have a keyboard. And what better keyboard than a super compact one like this? You know, if you're going to be using RetroPie on a arcade one-up or a regular arcade cabinet, obviously, no matter what size keyboard you have that's wired in, you're never going to be able to stand in front of your screen and access your keyboard at the same time. It's just, you're never gonna have a long enough cable for something like that. So something like this is super convenient to have, just even as a backup, if you're not gonna just, you know, leave it in there and utilize it whenever you need it. So that's gonna do it for today. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We do a whole bunch of gameplay demos, product reviews, and tutorials on here. And then of course, check us out online on our website, www.retropieguy.com. Thanks for watching.